So as I told you, that secondary cells are those cells in which we can actually reverse the electrode reactions, right? Because how we can reverse it? By supplying with external energy. That, so that means they do not, you can say, become dead. We can use as many times as we need it. So here I have an example for you, that is the lead storage cell. It is actually formed by the combination of two or three cells when are connected in series in order to generate a voltage of around 6 to 12 volt. So this is what is the lead storage cell, in which you can see this. These blue ones are the lead plates acting as anode. This, these blue ones with red lines, these are again, they are made, again made up of lead, a grid of lead with PbO2, right? And there is an electrolyte, this black one, that is the aqueous H2SO4. Lead plates as anode, lead this thing, lead grid with PbO2 is cathode, and aqueous H2SO4 is acting as an electrolyte. So what happened, what reaction occurs at anode actually? So what happens, like as we know that the lead has tendency to get oxidized, so obviously it will get oxidized. So it will lose two electrons, forming Pb2 positive. Now this Pb2 positive, because here is an electrolyte, that is there are hydrogen ions and sulfate ions present in the solution. So as Pb2 positive is formed, this Pb2 positive react with the sulfate ions from the solution, forming the PbSO4. So you can say that after the reaction, there is a layer of PbSO4 which starts depositing on it, the anode. So overall reaction is Pb plus SO42 negative, forming PbSO4 plus 2 electrons. This is what you get as the overall reaction for the anode. Now, at cathode, what happens? These 2 electrons obviously pass to pass there. There we know we have a grid of PbO2. Combines with 2 electrons, and there is an interaction with the hydrogen ions present in the solution. It forms Pb2 positive and it forms water. That means here the occurrence of reduction is there. So now, as we know that Pb2 positive has a great affinity for sulfate ions, so they will also form PbSO4, which will start depositing here. So we'll get a layer of PbSO4 surrounding the cathode as well. So the overall reaction is PbO2 plus H positive plus this thing SO42 negative, giving rise to PbSO4 and plus H2, and these 2 electrons also you need to write here. So these are the reactions which are occurring at cathode. So if you look for the overall, obviously it is the Pb plus PbO2 plus SO4 and H becomes H2SO4, so, and they are forming PbSO4 plus H2O. So this is what is the reaction. So that means with the passage of time, the hydrogen ions from the electrolyte is being used, the sulfate ions simultaneously is being used. So that means the concentration of H2SO will fall. That means the electrolyte will somehow start getting exhaust. And where is that electrolyte going? It is actually resulting in the formation of layer of PbSO4 on electrodes. And this will actually stop the reaction. So there we need the recharging now. So how we can just make it recharge, or how we can just reverse the direction reactions now? We'll supply it with the external energy of enough voltage which is capable of reversing the reactions. That means now these reactions are going to get reversed. That means when we are recharging, we are supplied with certain external energy source. It will just again forms Pb on anode, PbO2 at cathode, and H2SO4 will be discharged, will be present in the solution. So that means we can now use again this lead storage cell, because now we are again got the lead plates, a grid of lead with PbO2, again H2SO4. So again these reactions are going to just take place. Then again we'll get a coating of PbSO4. Again the cell will stop, and then again we'll supply it with the external energy, and the reactions will get reversed. So that means we can recharge it again and again, and we can use it as many times as we want. But the one more thing, so that means it can act as the voltaic cell as well as the electrolytic cell, because here when you are just making use of this spontaneous reaction, it is acting as a voltaic cell, because chemical energy is being converted into the electric energy. But once the concentration of H2SO falls, or you can say once these PbSO4 layer gets deposited on that, it is now going to act as an electrolytic cell, because here now we are going to supply it with the external energy in order to reverse the reaction. So that means it can also provide an external energy energy, and or you can, it can also used up in an external energy, so it can act as voltaic as well as electrolytic. And the major part is that we can reuse it again and again, as it is capable of recharging. So this is what is the lead storage cell. So now we will be taking a few more secondary cells, so just look at the board carefully.